Bomo praznovali krst.
Juhu. Looking forward to our candidates who want to follow Jesus in this manner.
Torej, kdor kaj.
The importance of baptism.
To nedeljo bi rad samo obnovil pomembnost krsta. Naj pri tej priliki omenim, če še kdo razmišlja, je seveda dobrodošel na krst za potopitvijo v vodo, tako kot Jezus.
There were two commands that Jesus gave us. One was baptism, the other is to observe his table.
Dve zapovedi nam je Jezus dal glede krsta in da obhajamo njegovo mizo.
It's not a suggestion.
To ni predlog.
But it was a command.
Ampak zapoved.
In Mark 16:16.
In Marko 16:16 pravi: Kdor bo sprejel vero in bo krščen, bo rešen. Kdor pa ne bo sprejel vere, bo obsojen.
In Acts 2 for the 38.
Apostolska dela 2:38 Peter jim je odgovoril.
They listened to Peter's message.
Poslušali so Petrovo sporočilo.
They were convicted.
Bili so od znotraj, jih je Sveti Duh prepričal.
What should we do, they asked.
In so vprašali, kaj naj storimo?
And Peter answered with clarity.
Peter jim je jasno odgovoril. Spreobrnite se. Vsak izmed vas naj se da v imenu Jezusa Kristusa krstiti v odpuščanje svojih grehov in prejeli boste dar Svetega Duha.
Baptism
krst
is an act that demonstrates
je dejanje, ki izkazuje
my repentance
moje spokorjenje
from running my own life.
Od tega, da sem vodil sam svoje življenje.
What I'm saying is that Jesus, you are now in charge.
A ne, z drugimi besedami rečem, Jezus, ti si zdaj moj šef.
It's no longer my life, but ne, I want you to live your life through me.
Ni več moje življenje, ampak želim, da ti živiš svoje življenje preko mene.
Water baptism is a symbolic act of identifying with his death and his resurrection.
Je simbolično dejanje, ki ponazarja njegovo smrt in vstajenje.
It represents our burial with him.
Predstavlja naš pokop skupaj z njim.
In which his death became the payment for our sins.
Ko je njegova smrt postala plačilo za naše grehe.
Jesus identified with us.
Jezus se identificiral z nami.
By becoming like us in our human flesh.
S tem, da je postal kakor mi v našem človeškem mesu.
And then he took our sins upon himself.
In potem je prevzel naše grehe nase.
When we follow him in baptism.
Ko mu mi sledimo v krstu.
We become like him and identify with him.
Postanemo kot on in se identificiramo z njim.
In his faith,
v njegovi veri,
and in his obedience to the Father.
In v njegovi poslušnosti očetu.
Jesus totally identified with us.
Jezus se popolnoma identificiral z nami.
And in water baptism we totally identify with him.
In ko se krstimo v vodi, se mi popolnoma identificiramo z njim.
He believed in us.
On je verjel v nas.
Now we believe in him.
In seveda sedaj mi verjamemo vanj.
And totally identify with him.
In se popolnoma identificiramo z njim.
Interestingly, Jesus in Luke chapter 12.
In zanimivo je, da je Jezus v Luku 12.
He identified his own death at the cross as a baptism.
Se identificiral za svojo smrt za krstom.
Yeah. Which wasn't done privately, it was done publicly.
Kar ni bilo storjeno nikje privat, ampak javno.
And our baptism is not a private thing.
Krst ni neka privat, izolirana stvar.
It's public, it's
ampak
open.
Je javno, je odprto.
We identify with Christ openly.
Identificiramo se za Kristusom javno.
Without being ashamed of being identified with him.
In nas ni sram, da smo identificirani skupaj z njim.
In Luke 9, verse 26.
V Luku 9:26 pravi.
If anyone is ashamed of me and my words, the Son of Man will be ashamed of him when he comes in his glory and in the glory of the Father and of his holy angels.
Kdor se sramuje mene ali mojih besed, se ga bo sramoval Sin človekov, ko bo prišel v svojem veličanstvu in veličanstvu Očeta in svetih angelov.
Can you imagine? Jesus loves to identify with you.
A si predstavljate, Jezus se rad identificira s tabo.
Many people are very concerned about their associations.
Mnogo ljudi skrbi zdaj, s kom so povezani.
Who they identify with,
s kom se identificirajo, s kom se družijo, s kom se ne.
And can you imagine?
In a si predstavljate?
That Jesus, God himself,
da Jezus, Bog sam,
he's not ashamed to identify with you.
Se ne sramuje, da se identificira, da je povezan s teboj.
He is proud of the fact.
On je dobesedno ponosen na to dejstvo.
And brez kanček zadržkov se popolnoma razveseli in uživa v to dejstvo, da je povezan s teboj. Wow. This phrase in Luke verse 26.
In ta fraza v Luku 9:26 je zanimiva.
Some translations they're not sure
enih prevodih ne vedo.
Kdo se sramuje meni ali moj besed? In some translations
in nekateri prevodi
različica
pravijo
mojih učencev.
Kdo se sramuje mene ali mojih učencev?
If you've been around the church long enough,
če si že dolgo časa v cerkvenih krogih,
you experience plenty of opportunities,
izkusiš veliko priložnosti,
to be ashamed of the church,
da bi se sramoval cerkve.
And when we say church,
in ko rečemo cerkev,
we're talking about specific people.
Pravzaprav govorimo o konkretnih ljudeh.
Cerkev ni nek splošen pojem. It's specific individuals that we've been identified
ja,
with.
To ni nek splošen pojem, ampak je v bistvu skupina ljudi, s katerimi se identificiramo.
And every one of us in this room has
in
to guard our heart from that experience.
Mora čuvati svoje srce, da ne bi izkusil tega.
Being ashamed of Jesus? No, I'm not ashamed of him.
Ne, Jezusa se ne sramujem.
Njegovih učencev.
Ampak.
And I want to encourage us in this room to guard your heart from that experience.
Da čuvamo svoje srce pred tako izkušnjo.
Jesus absolutely loves to identify with you.
Jezus se rad identificira s teboj.
And the worst person in your mind that you could think of.
Iz najhujšo osebo v tvojem umu, na katero lahko sedaj pomisliš.
Who considers themselves your brother and sister.
Ki se smatra za tvojega brata ali sestro.
Jesus is amazing.
Jezus je neverjeten.
His love is fantastic.
Njegova ljubezen je čudovita.
And he's warning us to be careful of becoming ashamed not only of him but also of his brothers and sisters, his followers.
Opozarja nas, da se ne bi sramovali njega ali da se ne bi sramovali njegovih učencev, njegovih bratov ali sestra.
He loves to identify with you.
Ker on se rad identificira s teboj.
And as a result, we are encouraged.
In zato smo tudi mi ohrabreni.
To love being identified with him
in this
world.
Identificiramo z njim v tem svetu.
Because baptism is an open declaration.
Ker krst je javna deklaracija.
And a demonstration to the world.
In demonstracija svetu, izkaz svetu.
Of our acceptance of Jesus Christ as Lord.
Da smo je javen prikaz tega, da smo sprejeli Jezusa Kristusa kot našega Gospoda.
Water baptism symbolizes my spiritual life that began.
V vodi simbolizira moje duhovno življenje, ki se je šele začelo.
I die to myself with him.
Umrem samemu sebi skupaj z njim.
And I come up out of the water to live a new life.
Z njim ustanem v novo življenje.
Energized by the Spirit of God, energized by Christ who now lives in me.
Duhom za Kristusom, ki sedaj prebiva v meni.
It gives me power over sin.
In to mi daje moč nad grehom.
Sin is no longer my master.
Greh ni več moj gospodar.
Christ is now my Lord.
Kristus je sedaj moj gospod.
And together with
gospodar,
him,
we learn. Sedaj skupaj za njim.
We learn to navigate this world.
Se učiva navigirati skozi ta svet.
Saying no to unrighteousness.
Ko rečeva ne brezbožnosti, nepravičnosti.
Putting off my old life.
Ko odvržem stare, odložim staro življenje.
The old man.
Starega človeka.
The life of the flesh.
Življenje mesa.
And I simply learn how to live a life led by the Holy Spirit.
In se enostavno učim živeti življenje, ki je vodeno po Svetem Duhu.
Not an easy task.
To ni lahka naloga.
But this is our inheritance.
Ampak to je naša dediščina.
The Lord's Supper, which we also celebrate.
Gospodova večerja oziroma obhajanje njegove mize, ki ravno tako praznujemo.
Symbolizes our spiritual life continued.
Simbolizira še naše duhovno življenje, ki se nadaljuje.
The first baptism.
Prvi krst.
Pictures faith in Christ.
Kaže vero v Kristusu.
The second pictures.
Drugo pa izkazuje
fellowship with Christ.
Druženje z Kristusom.
The first is done only once.
Prvo se stori enkrat.
There can only be one beginning of the spiritual life.
Piše, da je lahko samo en začetek duhovnega življenja.
But the second is done
ampak drugi
as frequently as possible.
Pogosto, kakor je možno.
Paul says, every time you meet,
Pavel pravi, vsakič, kadar se srečate,
is practical reasons
iz praktičnih razlogov, pač mi to enkrat na mesec storimo.
The second Sunday of every month,
drugo nedeljo v mesecu.
To celebrate communion, our
da praznujemo
connection,
to našo duhovno povezanost.
Teaching us that our spiritual life has to be nurtured.
Ki nas uči, da naše duhovno življenje mora biti negovano.
And we need to understand that we are baptized not
moramo razumeti, da smo krščeni
not in order to be saved, but because
ne zato, da bi,
we are saved.
Da bi bili odrešeni.
Not in order to be reconciled.
Zato, ker smo že odrešeni in ne zato, da bi bili spravljeni,
but because we already are reconciled.
Zato, ker smo že spravljeni.
In 1 Peter chapter 3,
in 1. Peter 3
Peter describes Noah and the ark
Peter
as a picture of
opisuje,
true baptism. Opisuje
Noa in to ladjo kot sliko krsta.
And in that passage it says that now baptism
pravi,
saves you.
Pravi, kaj pravi? Yes.
Baptism now saves
aha,
you.
Pravi, in zdaj te krst rešuje.
What's important to know is that Noah believed God before
kar je pomembno vedeti,
going through
da je
the flood.
Noa zaupal Bogu še predno se je pač zgodil potop. Po veri je bil Noa upeljan v stvari, ki še niso bile vidne. In v svetem strahu je naredil ladjo, da bi rešil svojo družino. Po veri je obsodil svet in postal dedič pravičnosti, ki je v skladu za vero.
Right? Noah and his family in the boat,
Noa
water,
in družina v ladji, vode jo preplavljajo.
From below and from above.
Od vzgore, od spodaj voda.
And that,
in
that
to
ark,
ta
and his family
ladja
is described
in
as
njegova
a baptism.
Družina je opisana kot da so bili krščeni, potopljeni so bili v vodo.
And the water of that flood
in voda
tega Noah and his family.
Potopa ni očistila Noeta in njegove družine.
Rather the fact that he and his family came through the flood,
ta družina je prišla je šla iz tega potopa
and were saved from its judgment.
In so bili rešeni obsodbe.
It was a testimony to their faith before the flood.
To, da so bili rešeni obsodbe, je bilo pričevanje že pred potopom.
It was their faith that caused them to believe God.
Njihova vera je bila tista, ki je povzročila, da so zaupali Bogu.
And built an enormous boat.
In da so gradili tako ogromno ladjo.
While the sun was shining.
Po veri, medtem ko je sijalo sonce.
For a long time.
Zelo dolgo časa.
In the face of all kind of ridicule.
In kljub temu, da so se jim ljudje posmehovali.
Noah believed.
Ampak Noah je v tistem času verjel, zaupal Bogu.
And their faith was a prerequisite.
In njegova vera
je bila through the waters.
Predpogoj, da so šli v vodo.
We are not baptized in order to be saved. We're baptized
nismo
because we are saved.
Nismo krščeni zato, da bi bili odrešeni, ampak se krstimo zato, ker smo že bili odrešeni.
And it's the logical next step in obedience to follow Christ.
To je povsem logičen korak poslušnosti, da sledimo Kristusu.
Because the true nature of the Christian life is to become an obedient life of following Jesus.
Narava krščanskega učenca je, da živi poslušno življenje in sledi Kristusu.
Let me note that Peter here describes baptism as a judgment.
Peter opisuje tukaj krst kot tudi kot sodbo.
Because the flood was a judgment upon sin.
Potop je bila sodba nad grehom.
And its horrifying effects.
In nad uničevalnimi posledicami greha.
As I said earlier, Jesus described his death as a baptism.
Jezus je opisal svojo smrt kot krst.
Because his death also carried out a judgment.
Njegova smrt je ravno tako nosila obsodbo.
Against the sin he was carrying.
On je obsodil ta greh, ki ga je nosil.
And likewise,
in ravno tako,
our baptism is a judgment.
Je naš krst tudi sodba.
Against the sin in our own life.
Zoper greh v našem lastnem življenju.
We judge our own sin.
Mi obsojamo svoj lasten greh.
We take sides against ourselves.
In zauzamemo pozicijo zoper nas same.
Every Christian has to learn
vsak kristjan se mora naučiti
to take sides against themselves.
Da zauzame pozicijo zoper samega sebe.
We will always have before us the ability to choose.
Vedno bo pred nami možnost izbire.
Whose influence, whose invitations.
Čigav vpliv, čigavo vabilo.
Whose words,
čigave besede, čigavo šepetanje bomo sprejeli oziroma poslušali.
Will we follow the whispers that,
ali bomo sledili,
that entertain and kind of tingle our flesh, something that would be self-serving?
Tem šepetom, ki žgečka našo meso, in ali bomo služili samim sebi?
Or will we follow the invitations that come from Christ?
Ali pa bomo sledili vabilu, ki prihaja od Kristusa.
And all of us have to learn to take sides against
in
ourselves.
Vsak izmed nas se mora naučiti zavzeti pozicijo zoper samega sebe.
There's a difference between a life in the spirit and life in the flesh.
Razlika med življenjem po duhu in življenjem v mesu.
And all of us have to choose to live a life in the spirit.
Izmed nas ima možnost, da se odloči, da živi življenje po duhu.
This is the freedom that Christ made possible for us.
To je ta svoboda, katero nam je omogočil Kristus.
It's not automatic, it requires my cooperation.
To se ne zgodi avtomatično, ampak zahteva moje sodelovanje.
Paul describes the flesh.
Pavel opisuje meso.
In essence, it's the union of my body and my soul, my thinking.
Sodelovanje, enotnost mojega telesa, moje duše, mojega načina razmišljanja.
To operate independently of God.
Da deluje neodvisno od Boga.
And Paul shares a whole list.
In Pavel podeli cel seznam.
Of the fruit of someone who lives their life
sadov nekoga, ki živi življenje
completely independent of God's influence.
Popolnoma neodvisno od Božjega vpliva.
When we go into the waters of baptism,
ko gremo mi v vode krsta,
we are declaring,
s tem oznanjamo,
I don't want that kind of life.
Jaz si ne želim take vrste življenja več.
I've already experienced the fruits
jaz sem
of that kind of life.
Že izkusil sadove takšnega življenja.
In s tem sem jaz končan. Zdaj želim drugače živeti. In grem skupaj z njim v vodo in prihajam iz tega z namenom, da bom dovolil, da Jezus vodi moje življenje in da je on šef nad menoj. In da sodelujem s svojim duhom, ki me vabi, da grem na ta avanturo skupaj z njim. Da lahko mi v skupaj
odreževa,
pokasaja, oziroma ne,
pokosiva,
ne. Ubijemo greh in njeno delovanje v mojem življenju, ker s tem se ne želim več sodelovati. Amen?
Amen.
We have to consistently take sides against ourselves.
Torej, vztrajno moramo zauzemati pozicijo zoper samega sebe.
That old person.
Ta, zoper to staro osebo.
That part called the flesh.
Starega človeka, oziroma to, kar Pavel imenuje meso.
That wants to act on its own initiative,
ki želi
apart from him.
Delati po svoje, neodvisno od Boga.
And if we turn from our sins,
in če se odvrnemo od svojih grehov,
and we go into water baptism,
in gremo v vode krsta,
we say, God, I agree with you.
Rečemo,
I'm judging
Bog,
that old
jaz
life.
Jaz se strinjam s tabo, jaz obsojam to moje staro življenje.
There's only one option for that way of life.
In samo ena opcija je za tako vrsto življenja.
And it's death.
In to je smrt.
Be gone. It's done.
Konc je, ne izgine.
And when we judge our own sins,
in ko obsodimo svoje lastne grehe,
then we have no fear of judgment.
Potem se nam ni treba bati sodbe.
From anyone else,
od kogarkoli drugega in še posebej
from God himself.
Od Boga samega.
The ad acta, konec. And as we sang earlier, righteousness,
prepeli pravičnost, svetost.
It's the gift.
To je dar, ki mi ga je Bog dal, ki me osvobaja.
That amazing exchange at the
cross. Ta neverjetna izmenjava, ki se zgodi.
No one can work for it.
Nihče si ne more tega prislužiti svojim trudom.
The gift of righteousness.
To je dar pravičnosti.
The gift of holiness.
Dar svetosti.
It's a gift that comes
to
us. To
je dar, ki nam ga Bog daje.
It's that position that he gives to us
to
as a free
pozicija,
gift.
Ki nam jo daje, povsem zaston.
By faith, not by works.
Ki jo sprejmemo po veri in ne po delih.
The New Testament teaches that water
Nova
baptism is for believers
uči,
only.
Da je krst samo za verne.
This is why we exclude children from
Zato
that baptism.
Izključimo male otroke, oziroma dojenčke iz krsta.
It's not wise to build doctrines or
ni modro
obligatory practices on assumptions from the Bible.
Doktrine na nekih predpostavkah iz Biblije.
Remember Noah?
Se spomnite Noata.
He believed before going through the flood.
Predno je šel v predno se je zgodila poplava.
Jesus commanded his disciples
Jezus
to make disciples and then baptize
them. Povedal svojim učencem, da naj oblikujejo, vzgajajo nove učence in potem naj jih krstijo.
In Mark 16,
Marko 16:16 pravi,
believing precedes baptizing.
Kdor veruje in je krščen, to se pravi vera je predhodnica krsta.
Philip preached the gospel
Filip
in Samaria. Filip
je oznanil evangelij v Samariji.
And those who were baptized,
tisti, ki so bili krščeni,
they first believed.
So najprej verovali. So začeli verjeti, ko pa so možje in žene začeli verjeti Filipu, ki jim je oznanil v evangeliju Božjem kraljestvu in v imenu Jezusa Kristusa, potem so se dajali krstiti.
Peter preached at Cornelius's house.
Peter je pridigal v Kornelijevi hiši.
And again, faith preceded
ponovno,
their baptism.
A ne, vera je bila predhodnica njihovega krsta.
Acts chapter 10.
Apostolska dela 10. Ko je Peter še govoril te besede, je prišel Sveti Duh nad vse, ki so poslušali besedo. Verniki iz obreza, ki so prišli s Petrom, so se čudili, kako da se dar Svetega Duha razliva tudi na pogane. Slišali so jih namreč, kako govorijo z darom jezikov in poveličujejo Boga. Tedaj je Peter spregovoril, ti ljudje so prejeli Svetega Duha tako, kakor mi. Ali mora kdo braniti, da ne bi bili tudi krščeni z vodo? In naročil je, na jih krstijo v imenu Jezusa Kristusa. Na to so ga prosili, naj ostane še nekaj dni med njimi.
Notice how,
opazite,
how eager God was to fill those believers with his spirit.
Kako je Bog komaj čakal, da napolni te vernike svetim duhom.
Peter's preaching,
Peter je pridigal,
and in Cornelius's house,
in v Kornelijevem domu,
they're agreeing, they're believing Peter
so
while he's speaking.
Verjeli Petru med tem, ko je Peter še govoril.
And the Holy Spirit comes on them.
In Sveti Duh je prišel nad njih.
Without anyone laying hands on them.
Brez da bi kdorkoli polagal roke na njih.
He didn't call them forward,
lay their hands on naprej, a ne tole vrsto. Ne, bi radi prejeli Svetega Duha, ja,
no,
in položil roke na njih in molil in tako
Peter's
naprej.
Preaching,
Peter je pridigal.
And they're believing while he's talking.
In ko on govori, oni zverujejo, imajo vero v srcu.
And their hearts are open.
In srca imajo odprta.
And the Holy Spirit comes to them.
Sveti Duh pride do njih.
And they start speaking in tongues out loud.
In začnejo na glas govoriti v jezikih.
That those who were visiting from Jerusalem,
zato da, in tako tisti, ki so bili obiskovalci iz Jeruzalema,
other Jews,
to se pravi drugi Judje,
checking out what's going on here
gledajo,
in this,
kaj pa se zdaj tukaj dogaja.
Pagan Gentile house.
V tej poganski hiši.
Cornelius is a Roman soldier.
Kornelij je bil rimski vojak.
And now they hear them speaking in other tongues.
Ga slišijo, kako vsi tam govorijo v jezikih.
Just like it happened in Jerusalem.
Ravno tako, kot se je zgodil na Binkošti v Jeruzalemu.
And there's such joy in the house.
In taka radost je v hiši.
And the only next logical thing for them to do.
In edina naslednja logična stvar je
was to go and be baptized.
Okay, dajmo jih zdaj krstiti.
And that's exactly what they did.
In to je točno to, kar so storili.
Yeah, incredible.
Neverjetno.
Then Paul with the Philippian jailer in Acts chapter 16.
Ko je bil v ječi.
You remember Paul and Silas are put in jail.
Se spomnite, Pavel in Sila bila sta v ječi.
It's midnight.
Polnoče.
Now keep in mind they're doing exactly what God's called them to do.
Delata točno to, kar jim je Bog naročil, da ne delata.
They get arrested.
Ujeta sta,
they get
aretirana, pretepejo ju.
They get beaten and then they're put in chains.
Pretepejo ju, dajo ju v verige.
And they're in a dungeon or a jail.
In sta res v najglobji jami, v luknji v zaporu.
This is the payment for faithfulness.
To je plačilo za njuno zvestobo.
And you can imagine Paul and Silas sitting in this.
Lahko si predstavljate, Pavel in Sila sedita.
I don't know how you would respond.
Jaz ne vem, kako bi se ti odzvala.
I'm not so sure how I would respond.
Jaz nisem prepričan, kako bi se jaz odzval.
But now I do know.
Ampak zdaj vem.
How someone responds when they are.
Kako se lahko nekdo odzove.
When they're filled and led by the Spirit.
Ko so izpolnjeni in vodeni po svetem duhu.
And Paul and Silas, they don't complain.
In Sila se ne pritožujeta, ne jamrata.
They don't start saying.
Ne rečeta.
I mean, is this the treatment?
To je to, a to si jaz zdaj zaslužim,
is
ne?
This the payment for
a to je zdaj plačilo?
For our faithfulness, for doing your will.
Za najino zvestobo, za to, da izvršujemo tvojo voljo.
I mean, I would expect a little bit better treatment than this.
Lepše ravnanje,
how about a hotel room instead of a jail house?
Kakšna hotelska soba namesto ječa.
But they don't do that.
Ampak ne delata tega.
They don't make excuses, they don't
ne
start doubting.
Se ne izgovarjata, ne dvomita.
Instead, they are absolutely sure that what they were doing was absolutely God's will.
100% prepričana, da to, kar počneta, je Božja volja.
And they weren't suffering for doing something wrong, they were suffering for doing something right.
Trpela zato, ker bi delala nekaj narobe, ampak sta trpela zaradi tega, ker sta delala nekaj prav.
And Paul says to Silas,
in Pavel reče Sili, hey,
you got a song?
A imaš kakšno pesem?
You want to sing?
A bi kaj zapela?
Aj, deva. And they start to praise. They start
začneta slaviti Boga.
To give thanks. They start
zahvaljevat.
Just to lift up
Christ. In pozigovat Kristusa.
I don't know the song they sang.
Ne vem, kakšne pesmi sta pela.
I wish we had the melody.
Bi si želel, da bi imel to melodijo.
Maybe the chords.
Mogoče se kaj nekaj akordov.
But I don't think that had anything to do with what happened next.
Ampak mislim, da to ni imel veze s tem, kar se je potem zgodil.
God responded not to the melody, he responded to their heart.
Bog se ni odzval na njuno melodijo, ampak se je odzval na njuno srce.
He loved the sacrifice that they were giving.
In všeč mu je bila ta žrtev slavljenja, ki sta jo mu prinesla.
In the middle of their pain, in the
sredi
their own suffering,
njune bolečine, sredi njunega trpljenja,
they started to praise him.
Sta začela slaviti Boga.
And God responds.
In Bog se je odzval.
Shakes the jail.
Pretrese ječo, potres v ječi, verige odpadejo.
Now is their chance to run.
In zdaj imata priložnost, da zbežita.
Ne.
Ampak, ne.
Instead, the jailer now responds.
He's
concerned about his own life.
Ker ječarja zdaj skrbi njegovo lastno življenje.
Oh no, what do we do?
Ne, kaj bomo pa zdaj?
And this is Paul's response.
Torej je Pavlov odgovor. Veruj Gospoda Jezusa in rešen boš ti in tvoja hiša. Na to sta oznanila Gospodovo besedo njemu in vsem, ki so bili v njegovi hiši. Vzel ju je sabo še tisto nočno uro, ter ima izprav rane in pri priči se je dal krstiti z vso svojo družino. Peljo ju je na svoj dom in ju povabil k mizi. In vesele je navdalo njega in vso njegovo hišo, ker so našli vero v Boga.
Hallelujah. I don't know what you might be suffering this morning.
Ne vem,
today.
Čez kaj greš v tem jutru.
I just want to say to you that on the other side of that,
reč, da na drugi strani,
there is some fruit for you. There's some.
Je sad za te.
There's something good on the other side of that trouble.
Je nekaj dobrega na drugi strani te stiske.
And I encourage you this morning,
in
believe.
Te ohrabrujem v tem jutru, da veruješ.
Don't fall into last week's
ne past v
message from Deanne to not fall into discouragement.
Ne past v malodušje, kot je Deanne prejšnji teden govorila.
Instead, find a song to
ampak
sing.
Najdi novo pesem, ki jo lahko zapoješ.
Find a way to lift up Jesus in the middle of that circumstance.
Kako lahko povzdigneš Jezusa sredi svojih okoliščin.
And you will become sensitive to the options that the Holy Spirit has for you.
Za razne opcije, ki jih ima Sveti Duh zate.
Because you are not a victim.
Ker ti nisi žrtev.
God has called you to be a victor in every circumstance.
Da si zmagovalec v vsaki situaciji.
It doesn't mean things are easy.
To ne pomeni, da bodo stvari lahke.
But instead he is with
ampak,
you.
Zavedaj se, da je on s teboj.
To turn that minus into a plus.
Da ta minus obrne v plus.
I don't know how it's going to happen.
In pojma nimam, kako se bo to zgodilo.
But it's your job and my job.
Ampak tvoja naloga in moja naloga je
to trust him.
Da mu zaupamo.
To lift him up.
Da ga povzdignemo.
To thank him in the midst of every circumstance.
Da se zahvaljujemo sredi vseh okoliščin.
Paul and Silas didn't thank God for the beating.
Pavel in Sila se nista zahvaljevala Bogu za to, da sta pretepena.
Thank you Jesus that the
hvala Jezus, da sva prebičena.
That the guy ripped my beard and he hit me in the head.
Da so mi spulal brado in da so me tolkali po glavi.
That's crazy.
To je noro.
No, we give thanks
mi se zahvaljujemo
Bogu
sredi takih težkih okoliščin.
Not for everything.
Ne za vse.
But in the midst of everything.
Ampak v vsaki situaciji, sredi vsega.
And as a result, your spirit
in posledično se tvoj duh
becomes sensitive and open
in postane občutljiv na delovanje Svetega Duha.
That God, the Holy Spirit, has for you.
Ki jih ima Bog Sveti Duh zate.
In the middle of that circumstance.
Sredi te situacije.
If you give in to malodušje,
če pa se predaš malodušju,
our vision becomes clouded.
Potem je tvoja vizija postane zamegljena.
We start going down the road of depression and isolation.
In začneš iti po poti depresije in izolacije.
Instead we have to cooperate with God the Holy Spirit.
Tega moramo sodelovati z Bogom in za Svetim Duhom.
And like Paul and Silas, we give thanks.
In tako kot Pavel in Sila, da se zahvaljujemo Bogu tudi v polnoči.
When it's dark.
Ko je vse temno.
When there seems to be little to give thanks for.
Ko zgleda, kot da je malo stvari, za kar bi lahko bili hvaležni.
When Jesus began his ministry in Mark.
In ko je Jezus začel svojo službo.
It says that he came preaching the gospel of the kingdom.
Pravi, da je oznanjeval sporočilo Božjega kraljestva.
And he said, repent and believe in the gospel.
Pokorite se in verujte evangeliju.
We said at the outset that baptism is an act that demonstrates
in smo rekli, da je krst dejanje, ki izkazuje
my repentance from running my own life.
Moje spokorjenje od tega, da sem sam vodil svoje življenje neodvisno od Boga.
And each of us must come to the place
in vsak od nas mora priti do te točke
where we believe that it's actually good to have no rights of our own.
Kjer začnemo verjeti, da je dobro, da nimamo svojih lastnih pravic.
We're learning to live a life that's totally dependent on him.
Učimo živeti življenje, ki je povsem odvisno od njega.
Jesus didn't do anything of his own initiative.
Jezus ni storil ničesar iz svoje lastne inicijative.
He listened to his father.
Poslušal je svojega očeta.
He watched his father.
Opazoval je svojega očeta.
And he said what the father said.
In je rekel to, kar je rekel oče.
And he did what the father did.
In je delal to, kar je delal oče.
The person who has seen the kingdom.
Oseba, ki je videla Božje kraljestvo.
Joyfully lets Jesus have the control.
Radostno dovoli Jezusu, da prevzame kontrolo.
Of all things in their life.
Vseh stvari v njegovem življenju.
Jesus said, I've come to preach the gospel of the kingdom.
Jezus je rekel, prišel sem oznanjevat kraljestvo, oznanjevat evangelij kraljestva.
The gospel of the kingdom is who's evangelij in charge of my life.
Kraljestva pomeni, kdo ima glavno besedo v mojem življenju.
That
kdo
is
je
the
šef.
Issue.
To je stvar, v bistvu, za katero se gre.
And as real believers,
in kot Bogu predani verniki.
We repent from self-government.
Se spokorimo od samovlade.
And we move to God-government.
In se premaknemo v Božjo vladavino.
To Jesus's government in our life.
Jezus vlada v našem življenju.
And that is great news.
In to je ta dobra novica.
Because whatever Jesus gets to become in charge of,
karkoli dovolimo Jezusu, da vlada,
flourishes and prospers.
Vsako tako področje potem lahko prosperira in napreduje.
It's like our garden.
Kot na primer naš vrt.
You give Mateja neko rastlino.
Daš Mateji eno rastlino.
And trust me, it's gonna flourish.
In bo začela cveteti, bo začela rast.
Something that's in her hands.
Nekaj, ki pride v njene roke.
Kar se tiče rastline, imamo take
hortenzije.
Hortenzije. So tako težki, da kar padem na tleh. Pa tudi rože. So tako velike slike, morate videti. Je neverjetno. When something becomes his,
bom objavila. Ko neki pride v njegove roke.
When it becomes under his care.
Ko pride pod njegovo skrbo.
When you are under his stewardship,
ko si ti pod njegovim oskrbništvom,
you will flourish.
Potem boš cvetel.
You will prosper.
Boš napredoval.
You become emotionally well.
Ti bo čustveno dobro.
Because he talks to you in loving
zato,
ways.
Ker on se pogovarja s tabo na ljubeč način.
He wants to repair that self-image.
Želi popraviti tvojo samo podobo.
That others have damaged and
ki se je mogoče drugi poškodovali.
In many cases we ourselves have cooperated. We've said things to ourselves about ourselves.
Na nek način smo tudi sami sodelovali s tem, ko smo sami sebi govorili stvari ali pa na določen način razmišljali o sebi.
That just aren't true.
Ko smo sprejeli stvari, ki niso resnične.
And when you become his property,
in ko postaneš njegova lastnina,
he begins to work on that,
on začne
on you,
delati na tebi,
internally,
od znotraj,
in your mind, in your
v tvojem umu, v tvojem duhu,
because he wants that which has now become his to
ker želi, da to, kar je
sedaj
njegovo, prosperira in napreduje, cveti.
And when we step into the waters
in
of baptism,
ko vstopimo v vode krsta,
and it's a reminder to all of us who've already made that step in our life.
Je to opomnik za vsakogar izmed nas, ki je že storil ta korak.
Together with them, we will declare.
Skupaj z njimi oznanimo.
We're going to declare with Sasha.
Skupaj s Sašo.
With Neža.
In z Nežo.
Death to the old self.
Smrt staremu človeku, smrt samemu sebi.
Stara Saša, konec. Yay! That's reason to celebrate.
In to je razlog, da praznujemo, da se veselimo.
And when they come out of the water,
in ko pride ven iz vode,
we declare with them, for them, and with ourselves.
Z njimi, in za njih in sami sase.
Jesus, we welcome
Jezus,
your
rule. Jezus, ti si dobrodošel. Dobrodošla je tvoja vladavina v mojem življenju.
We welcome your stewardship over our life.
Dobrodošlo tvoje skrbništvo mojega življenja.
Because I know that whatever you have,
vem, da karkoli imaš ti, karkoli česarkoli si ti ta glavni,
prospers and flourishes.
To področje potem cveti in napreduje.
Amen.
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 Father, we thank you this morning.
Oče, hvaležni smo ti v tem jutru.
That you are sitting on the throne.
Sediš, da ti prestoluješ.
Despite all that's going on in this world.
Ne glede na to, karkoli se dogaja v tem svetu.
We know from your word
se zavedamo iz tvoje besede, da si ti glavni.
That you're working all things out to your intended
end. Ti oblikuješ vse stvari do svojega namena.
And Father, we're here this morning.
In Oče, tu smo v tem jutru.
To declare we want to work together with you.
Da oznanjamo, da želimo sodelovati s teboj.
We declare.
Mi oznanjamo.
That old life.
Da je to staro življenje, star način življenja. Ne želim več sodelovati z njim.
I never want the old Steve to arise.
Nočem, da stari Steve ustane.
So I choose to keep him dead.
Torej se odločam, da ga ohranjam mrtvega.
And when it's necessary, I take sides against
myself. Kadar je potrebno, bom zavzel pozicijo zoper samega sebe.
And I choose to follow Christ.
Odločam, da sledim Kristusu.
I welcome the Holy Spirit.
Sveti Duh, ti si dobrodošel.
Again this morning.
Ponovno te molim.
Lead me and guide me.
Vodi me, usmerjaj me.
Father, I pray for each one of us.
Prosim za vsakogar izmed nas.
That we would be alive to you.
Da bomo živi zate.
Welcoming the Holy Spirit.
Da si ti dobrodošel, Sveti Duh.
Welcoming Jesus's rule.
Da si ti dobrodošel, Jezus.
In every step we take.
Vsaki koraku,
in every thought
in
we think,
misli, ki jo razmišljamo,
in every decision
in
that
vsaki
we make,
odločitvi, ki jo delamo.
Jesus, we give you the advantage, we give you the first place.
Dajemo tebi prvo mesto.
And we declare not only with our words,
in oznanjamo ne samo z našimi besedami,
but with our life,
ampak z našim življenjem.
Jesus
Jezus
is Lord.
Je Gospod.
Jesus
Jezus
is Lord.
Je Gospod.
Father, we bless Sasha, Neža and others.
Blagoslavljamo Sašo in Nežo.
We're making the decision to follow you.
Če se kdo še odloča, da ti sledi v poslušnosti.
They trusted you and believed you.
In sem tem, ki so ti že zverovali in ti zaupajo.
And as a result, you've already brought amazing changes in their life.
Ti si že naredil toliko sprememb v njihovem življenju.
We pray that you'd keep working in them.
In molimo, da ti še naprej deluješ v njih.
And as they join this army of Christ's followers.
In ko se pridružujejo tej vojski Jezusovih učencev.
Father, I pray that each of us.
Očka, molim, da bi vsakdo izmed nas.
Would be sensitive to you.
Bil občutljiv na tvoje delovanje.
Alive to you.
Živ zate.
And once again this morning we make the
choice. In ponovno v tem jutru se odločamo.
To say Jesus, you are Lord.
Rečemo, Jezus, ti si Gospod.
Lead us by your spirit.
Vodi nas po tvojem svetem duhu.
In Jesus' name.
V Jezusovem imenu.
Amen.
Amen. Amen.